What's up, guys? So to complete this custom, we're gonna need about 4 colors. The first color is our green color, which is a mixture of avocado, olive, yellow, and flat white. The next color is our yellow color, and that's a mixture of flat white and yellow. And the last 2 colors require no mixing, and they are flat white and flat black. All right, now that we have our colors, let's get into some painting. First things first, we need to make the side panel a pure white. This is going to take about 8 to 9 coats to do, since we want to completely cover up the canvas material in order to have a nice smooth surface. Next, we're going to completely cover the white panel with about 4 to 5 coats of our yellow color. Now, for this part, you can completely do this by hand, but I'm addicted to the stencil life now, so I'm gonna use this stencil I created to make the camel pattern. I do wanna sell the stencils I make, but I don't have a super professional cutter right now, so the edges aren't completely perfect. However, they completely worked for me, so if you guys wanna buy them for the low, I'll definitely have the link to that in my description below. To apply it to the shoe, we're gonna use some transfer tape. Lay it over the stencil and then peel it from its backing. Place it on the shoe and use a heat gun to secure the vinyl down. Once it's placed, peel the transfer tape off while securing any unwanted pieces from coming up. One really important step is to run your heat gun over the vinyl so it suctions down to the shoe. Next, we're gonna grab our green color and fill in the spaces around the vinyl with about 5 to 6 coats. Once we take the stencil off, we should get a really nice two-tone camo pattern. Alright, camo pattern down, let's move on to the LVs. To do this, I'm going to be using a stencil as well, and I will have the link to this in my description below. We're going to repeat the same steps to get the vinyl onto the shoe. Lay transfer tape over it, smooth out any air bubbles, remove it from its backing, place it on the shoe, and remove the transfer tape. Once we have our stencil on, we're gonna use a smaller brush to fill in the stencil with about 4 to 5 coats of flat black. It's gonna be a bit hard to fill the areas with ridges, so make sure you hold the stencil down to avoid any leaking or disfiguring any of the shapes. When done, we can use tweezers to slowly remove the stencil and go back in with a paintbrush to fix any noticeable mistakes. And lastly, since we're working on canvas, we don't need a finisher, but we can spray some water and stain repellent to protect the shoes from the elements.